wind turbines, hydroelectric dams, solar panels, and nuclear power plants are just some of the ways we use to meet the energy demands of modern cities. But as effective as they are, these approaches still have flaws. Turbines are useless without wind, dams are useless when the water runs out, solar panels are useless at night, and nuclear power plants have terrible aesthetics. In addition to these, the energy they provide don't last forever. Wind runs out when there aren't enough plants to convert carbon dioxide to oxygen. Dams rise and fall based on the position of the moon. The sun will eventually die out in a few billion years. And the nuclei used in nuclear power plants will just eventually disappear. But worry not, there is a way to create infinite energy. Infinite energy can be made through what is called a perpetual motion machine. A perpetual motion machine is a machine that is perpetually in motion. But on its own, a perpetual motion machine will not be able to create energy that can be harvested. To create a perpetual motion machine capable of fueling our cities, we need two things. Six cats and a sphere. And some tape. As we all know, cats will always land on their feet. There are documented cases of cats surviving from falling from the 32nd floors of buildings. When they fall, cats will reflexively twist their bodies so that their feet face the ground. Thus, if we strap two cats back to back and toss them off a balcony, both cats should make an attempt to land on their feet. Unfortunately, just strapping two cats together will result in both cats landing on their hind legs. The same happens if we strap four cats together back to back. What you get will be four cats landing on their hind legs together. To create the nucleus of our perpetual motion machine, we're going to need no less than six cats and a sphere. Tying all six cats with their backs to the sphere, and tossing them off a platform, will cause none of the cats to land on their feet. Instead, they will be left suspended in midair, spinning erratically, as one cat attempts to dominate all over the others. What we now get is a perpetually spinning sphere. By attaching lines within the sphere, we can attach it to a turbine, into an engine, and create infinite energy.